All right, welcome, folks. We'll get started. The chapel is going to start us off with a prayer.
Let's bow our heads. Almighty God, we gather here today to remember the life of Patrolman Sonny Vaughn, who made the ultimate sacrifice of a law enforcement officer in protecting our community and enforcing the law 80 years ago today. Almighty God, as we take this time to memorialize Patrolman Vaughn, we pray for all those who have given the ultimate sacrifice throughout our nation. We pray for the 137 officers of the Burlington Police Department and officers all over our nation as well. We also ask, Lord, your constant protection upon our officers and bless them and their families as well. Help us all to be a positive influence in our community and a constant source of love and encouragement to our fellow law enforcement officers and families. Thank you, Almighty God, for hearing our prayers and for your mercy and grace. In your name we pray. Amen.
Raise your arms.
Thank you all for coming today. So again, this is the 80th anniversary of the death of Patrol Officer Sonny Vaughn. Our commitment with the Burlington Police Department is to always honor his sacrifice. Every year we will do something, whether it's graveside, we did the sign last year, we did one year at the lobby of the police department. We will do something and encourage you to perpetuate his memory with your family. We encourage other family members to attend the brief service, but it's heartfelt. It's my honor to be here. Our officers are honored to be here to salute your family's commitment and sacrifice through the death of your grandfather and grandfather too?
All of them.
Okay, all right. So as I mentioned to the other folks, we do also a memorial in May. And it's a countywide memorial, and you're always welcome at that as well. The weather's generally a little nicer, and it's a much more formal hour-long service in a church, and you're welcome to attend that. But our commitment is to always honor Sonny Vaughn's death and the sacrifice that he made. I want to thank everybody for coming today, especially the county. We appreciate your presence here as well. I know you lost an officer in this same tragic event, and we honor both of those men every time when we do this. So thank you for that. Chaplain.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord look on you with his love and gracious favor. The Lord grant you his peace and keep you safe. Yeah. Amen.
Chief, could I possibly say something?
Absolutely, you bet.
Honored to be here today. See, this occasion is a time that you officers might have an open ear to someone that's not on the battlefield with you. But Sonny Bones stood on that battlefield. He had a spouse, children, loved ones, and friends just like you do. Then on December 7, 1938, he would never get his time to put his call in for the end of watch. But I think he's still on duty in spirit. And I think he'd tell each one of you, humble yourself, drop that air of arrogance, because it only leads to destruction. Be just, treat others as you wanted to be treated, because compassion leads to trustworthiness. Be honest, trusting the law will prevail. Be slow to anger. Anger only leads to chaos and blindness to the truth of your surroundings. Know your strengths and admit to yourself your weaknesses. Be aware, evil hides around every corner. Know your surroundings. You are on the battlefield. Be strong in faith. Your strength comes from the Lord, and He is your shield. Pray every day. A wise man asks God for intuition, for protection, for courage, for peace at the end of the day. I think my grandfather Mike would say, you see, officers, you're the bright spot in the darkness. And when light shines, darkness has no place in that space. Shine bright for those you love and those you serve, and you will be rewarded.
Love those comments. So go forth and shine brightly, gentlemen and ladies. Thank you very much for attending today.